For your precious holy word, and thank you, Father, for your precious people. Let them have listening ears tonight, and hearts will be receptive. Now I pray their minds will be alert, Lord, that we'll hear your word and be doers of it. We thank you for all your blessings, and we trust the Holy Spirit to have liberty. Not my will, Father, but your will be done. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Well, go shake hands with two or three people. Tell them you love them. You're glad they're here. We're teaching on that. Don't let your heart be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. Too many people, man. When you know, I always teach this. I've been sharing this. That you can't really find out where you at with God until a test comes. When something go wrong, man, you find out where you at. Them tests will tell on you. They'll tell you ain't all that that you've been claiming to be. Hello, y'all. That didn't get much response. Yep. Them tests and trials will show you up. I mean, you was all happy Sunday after church, and then Monday afternoon you got stunned. And so I've over the years walking with the Lord for over 20 years, being full time in the ministry for over 22 years. I just lived a little different from a lot of believers. And I'm not, you know, I don't know it all. But I am confident in what Jesus done taught me. I done saw it work here today. And so the way I live as a Christian, as the Lord taught me as a baby Christian, was any area I struggled with, I trusted him to teach me. There was a struggle in that no more. I never kept struggles. I never walked in them. And it's amazing, people that have been in the Lord 5, 10, 15, 20 years and still, one little thing bother you all day. That's amazing. You still icked about stuff. This still gets on your nerves. And I don't have nothing to do me like that. And so, I've always learned to trust in the Lord. Where that I never live in troubles. I never allow my heart to stay troubled by nothing. Nothing. Neither let it ever be afraid. Now how do you do that? Well, John 14, 27, Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you." So see, Jesus left something with us. "My peace I give unto you. Not as the world give I unto you." And then Jesus come with these astounding words. "Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." Oh, that's trouble. I meet people and ministers and around the country, and I talk to people, you know, and you hear people say, "Man, I tell you, we've been going through it for 2 years. 2 years? Where was the Lord at?" "Boy, I tell you, we've been under financial strain," and they don't even realize what they're saying. They don't even realize because they ain't been trusting the Lord. But they think they have. Christians think they've been trusting the Lord, and really ain't been trusting Him. And you can just say this, think this, hope this, wish this. But Jesus has got to come through. I can't live Him. I can't walk with Him and He don't come through. The word peace here notes the absence of strife. A state of untroubled and undisturbed well-being. This is what Jesus left us. His peace. His peace, you all. This peace is such a state that it's the object of divine promise. And it's brought about by God's mercy, granting deliverance and freedom from all the distresses that are experienced as a result of sin. All the distresses. Anytime distress is in our lives, sin's there. Or really what Jesus ain't. When trouble comes to us, I always teach this. When trouble comes to you, He ain't came. When He comes, trouble goes. They're never there together.
That's good. Yes, yes, yes.
You can't have trouble and peace mixed together at the same time. And so, when my heart gets troubled, I know I need to get to Jesus and get His peace. I at least need to know, and I pray y'all get this and take this with you forever. This is the lowest that anybody been born again ought to ever live. This is the lowest you should ever go in your life. You should never live beneath this. And that is, Jesus knows what to do. You ought to at least be there. That's the least. Is when you have trouble that Jesus know what to do. That's the least. Oh, I tell you, man. I'm a pastor, I know. When I was a pastor, I knew. You know, people say, somebody, you know, died in their family. They say, first thing they say, we don't have money to go. But Jesus got the money to go. Well, we just can't afford it. But Jesus can afford it. Well, we just don't know what to do. Well, Jesus know what to do. See, it's peace in Him. It's always peace in Him. You might still not know what to do, but He always knows what to do. And the only way you're going to not let your heart be troubled is you understand who He is and what He's did for you. Jesus said, my peace. Give me the New Living Translation. He said, peace I leave you as a gift. One thing about troubles and fears, they cannot mess up Jesus' peace. Jesus' peace will mess them up. It's nothing we go through in life that ever messes up Jesus. We have to know this so when we know we trust in Jesus, He's going to mess up what we're going through. I live in this everyday saints. Life is a joy. I enjoy the life of Christ. It's a joy, saints. I was enjoying it 20 years ago when I didn't hardly have no money. But I was full of joy and peace, and the Lord was working in my life. And it's just a joy to live in the Lord. You don't have to take no breaks when you're not stirred up about the Lord. You don't have to do that. I see people in church just kind of fall off. He's not their peace. So Jesus gives us His peace as a gift. Everything you get from Jesus will be a gift. You will never live right to get nothing from God. You will never keep commandments and get nothing from God. Everything that God gives you in Jesus is a gift. that has to be received by faith. And really, faith, saints, is believing in who Jesus is and what Jesus did. Let me quote you a verse. Turn to Romans 1, verse 16 and 17. And this breaks it down. What I'm not ashamed of the gospel, the good news of Christ. Who is it the good news about? By Jesus. For it is the power of God and the salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. Now verse 17. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. Really, righteousness is the obedience of Jesus. By the obedience of one man, many were made righteous. So God is imputing to us how perfect Jesus lived, and he imputed to Jesus on the cross how ugly we lived. He let Jesus suffer what we did wrong so we could be blessed in what Jesus did right. Romans 5:19 says, by the disobedience of one, many were made sinners. So by the obedience of one, many are made righteous. We are never to live where we're trying to obey God to get God to bless us. We are to look to Jesus and how he obeyed God perfect, and let that be imputed to us where we live in believing in him and do what he tells us to do every day. And people are trying. This stuff ain't working. How do you know, Pastor? Because it don't work all the time. When you get a revelation in the Lord, it works all the time. It don't never take a break. Any revelation you have from the Lord, it works every day in your life. If it don't work, it's not a revelation from Jesus. And so by his obedience, so 1:17. So for therein is the righteousness of God revealed. And it's revealed from faith to faith. Your first faith receiving his love shed abroad in your heart. Your next faith is to take how Jesus loved you and live that again. Let him love you again. Your first faith was to let him love you to bring you into the kingdom. Your next faith is to let him love you through your tests and through your trials and through your prosperity and through your blessings. It's from faith to faith. Yeah. Now, look, the just. Now get this, saints. This will help you. The just shall live by Jesus. I know it say faith, but if you don't know who faith is, I think we just came up with something for faith to try to get stuff from God. But I'm going to tell you, the greatest faith you'll ever have is the faith that overcomes the world. And who is he that overcomes the world? He that believeth Jesus is the Son of God. And I'm going to tell you something, saints. If you learn what Jesus taught me, that before I go and try to trust the Lord, I always look to Jesus. Jesus is the only man who walked on this earth, got everything from God. He knows how to get everything from God. He got everything from God. Jesus knows how to make everything work. So how do I want to come work? I believe he did. Before I go trust him, I believe he went through this in victory. That's what I live by. I live by Jesus went through this in victory. Now let me give you scripture for that. John 16:33. Turn that real quick. Because we're going somewhere tonight. We're going somewhere. Y'all ought to get on the run tonight. You ain't gonna stay in your seat. I mean, some of y'all ain't ran around the pews in a long time. They're probably going to get on the run tonight. Because people get stagnated in this. And they act like way they can't shout no more, man. You know. But why did you shout years ago? What made you shout? What made you run and dance and jump years ago? Where'd that go? God ain't changed. No, you was excited about this thing. Something was stirring on the inside of you. And that needs to be rebirthed. These things have I spoken unto you. Let me tell y'all something and give y'all a revelation Jesus gave me earlier this year. He said, always remember, whenever you have troubles, something from him need to be spoke to you. Let me say that again. Anytime you go through something in life, Jesus need to speak something to you. These things have I spoken unto you, that in me you will have peace. Now, what's in him? What does it mean in him? In who he is, the one sent from God, and what he did. That's him. It is not his name. It is who he was, the one sent from God, and he knows everything and accomplished everything that can ever be accomplished in Jesus' name. Now that's in him. He's got everything figured out, everything accomplished. He's got all our victories already won. He's got all our prosperity already done. He's got all our healing already done. He's got all our deliverance already done. He's got all our peace already done. He's got all our joy already done. He's got all our strength already done. He has got and already finished everything that he wants us to accomplish here on this earth. He's already got it finished. I'm talking about in him. He said in me. So watch. So you don't have his revelation. If whenever you go through something, you don't realize that's not in him. And I've been recognizing it for over 20 some years. I know that ain't him when I'm troubled or in fear. I know that's not him. So I run to him and get that out. And let him get that out in him. This is so hard for people. Jesus said, in me you have peace. So you know when you don't have the absence of strife, the absence of lack, the absence of undisturbed, untroubled, when you don't have the absence of that, you really have the absence of Jesus working. I'm not talking about being born again. I'm talking about Jesus working in your life. He said, in me you have peace. Any kind of trouble, anything bothering you, anything. He said, let not your heart be troubled. Most people never have proof in this. Neither let it be afraid. Oh God, what are we going to do? Shoot, I'm going to believe Jesus, no. There's so much peace when you just say that. Well, the Lord knows. Jesus knows exactly what to do. Right there, peace just came to you. It's in him. In the world, you're going to have some tribulation. Oh, yes. You're going to have some frustration. How many of y'all have had some this today? How about this week? Amen. I ain't had nothing this week. I mean, I just ain't had one. But that don't mean it couldn't come, you understand? Now ask me, have I had some this year? I'll put both hands up. But it's probably stayed by 5 seconds. Really, I'm not being sarcastic. It's really 5 seconds. I just done grew in this. It's just the easiest thing in the world, me to get over stuff. Just too quick. I forgive just like this and forget anything. I never let none stay in my mind that's against Jesus' work on the cross. I just constantly keep peace in my thinking and from my spirit. So Jesus said in the world, everything's not going to go away. Because he said, I'm not giving you peace like the world give it to you. And so he said, but be of good cheer. Now I want you to see this now so you can catch the revelation. He did not teach you here to trust for your situation to change. He didn't teach that. He didn't teach that for you to say, it's going to be all right. We're going to trust the Lord in this. Let me tell you what he taught. And you can run with this. He said, first, to be a good cheer. And you got to know what the cheer is about. The cheer, y'all, is he done did something about what you facing.
Glory, hallelujah.
And that is what you are to walk by every day in your walk with him, is to believe that Jesus done did something about everything we could face in this life.
Amen. Amen.
He done did something about it. And so what he tell you is, be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. He's not telling you you can. He's not telling you to believe that you can. He's telling you to believe that he did, so you can trust him to show you how. And you ought to hear people trying to believe for themselves. They trying to believe for themselves with no Jesus in there helping you that he's accomplished this. Are y'all listening? Oh, we believe in God, but they don't have no Jesus that done did that. We don't believe in God.
Come on.
And then you don't see it.
That's good.
But what would you put Jesus in there? That he's overcome work. I like the Amplified Bible. It said, he's deprived the world of power to harm us and conquered it for us. So let me show y'all what I do with problems. Troubles. Fears. I said, now you're a trouble. You're a problem and you're a fear. But Jesus done whooped you. I can't whoop you. But I sure know who did. And I'm going to trust him because he's going to show me how. And I'm going to triumph over you the same way he did, in the same strength and power he had from God, going to work in my life same way. And it has 20-something years. Always looking at Jesus. Look at Jesus. Jesus accomplished it. Jesus overcame this. Jesus can fix this. Jesus can handle this. Jesus can do it. Jesus. See, we both have a mind of Christ. And people trying their best to believe. It don't work. They always trying to believe for something. And they missing Jesus. They missing Jesus. Jesus said, come unto me. He never told you to try to trust God and work out no problems. He said, come to me. Every time you're laden and heavy laden, he said, always here, come to me first. They have been in church for years and ain't done this stuff. He said, I'll give you rest. Anytime I ain't got no rest, I know I ain't been with Jesus. Anytime I got rest, I know I've been with him. That's how I know I walk with him every day. Whoever keep his word, in him verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby know we in him. 1 John 2:5. This is how you know you in him. When his love is working in your life every day. You're supposed to just be saying, I know the Lord with me. And he ain't doing nothing. Y'all still love me? Watch Kevin. He overcame the world. Who is he that overcomes the world? The person that believes that Jesus did. And he shows you how. And he wants to everybody. He said, come to me. All you that labor and heavy laden. He didn't tell you stop believing nothing. He said, come to him and believe. And he said, I'll give you rest. Take my yoke. He wants you to take on him. Take what's on him and get that thing shot on you. He said, take my yoke. So he don't even want you to have no yoke. They said he is. And then Jesus said, learn of me. For I am meek. The word meek in the Greek. One translation I studied said, a spirit of attitude in which you accept God's dealings with you as good and do not dispute or resist it. Jesus said, I got that kind of meek and humble spirit. I never resist what God say do. I'm meek and lowly in heart. I never resist nothing God say do. And then he said, you are fanned. So this is lost. When you're in your troubles, you got to fan this. He said you will fan rest in your soul. So that rest has to be found. Oh, y'all didn't hear that, did you? I said that rest got to be found. For his yoke is ease and his burden light. He said, listen, y'all, what I'm going to put on you is going to be ease. I ain't never seen nothing in my 20-some years walking with the Lord been hard. I've seen stuff feel hard. I've seen stuff look hard. But with Jesus, I ain't never seen nothing hard. The devil just putting pressure on you, making you think stuff is hard. But Jesus said, I've conquered that stuff for you. I've conquered it for you. The pride and the power to harm you. You have to believe in him. You got to believe in him. He won. He overcame. He triumphed. It's his victory. It ain't ours. It's his. And what does he want to do? Go to John. I'm a little bit ahead of myself. But go to John 16, verse 13. Y'all bring your shouting clothes on.
Yeah.
It's hard to read this. How be it when he, the spirit of truth, is come? You sure he's okay? You know, I might be trying to look for him. He's okay. Who? The spirit of hope? Spirit of truth? What is this spirit of truth? This is Jesus in spirit. And Jesus said, when he will guide you in all truth. So you have to put yourself in a position every day where that the Holy Spirit can guide you. So you can't be in control. That is what we're going to do. You're always making plans. And ain't that the Lord? I came down here for years. We didn't take no vacation until I was 7 years old in the Lord. I be seeing people trying to take a vacation and broke. Listen, you need to wish. We took our son to the zoo and took him to the park and bought a loaf of bread and fed the ducks and had fun with the Lord and won people to Jesus out there. We never tried to do stuff and we didn't have money for it. We waited till God blessed us. The Spirit is not putting you under pressure. Borrowing money, going out trying to have no fun. They're taking no vacation. You rest at home. Get you one of them long chairs and act like you at the beach and go out there and lay down in the sun till you get some money. You ain't got no business trying to go on no vacation and you broke. And we just waited on God. All our money came down here and rained. All our vacations came here for 7 years to hear the word. Till we got to a place where we could come and do this and then go do something else too. I waited on God. I kept trusting the Lord. Now I'm totally debt free. And when I wasn't debt free, I wasn't wanting for nothing. And I've learned to be content. When I have or don't have, I know how to stand and trust the Lord and to stay happy that Jesus is in love with me.
Yeah.
I ain't got to have stuff to be happy. My joy comes from the Lord. That he's in love with me and he is with me and he'll never leave me and he'll never forsake me. And I got confidence in him that he's going to be with me always. That's my joy. That's my joy. He will guide you in all truth. I never paid interest on credit cards. I never stole from banks so I could go buy clothes. I never stole money from the banks so we could have furniture in our house. I saved up for years while we was in an apartment. I saved up and I bought $50-some thousand worth of furniture for our house in 2000.
Glory.
I saved up $38,000. The other $17,000 came in doing 6 weeks when I went and bought the furniture. I saved up. I would never have been under pressure and stress. If God don't tell me to do something, I don't do it. I don't buy no house trying to believe God he gonna pay for it. I hear from God before I go buy the house, and I know he gonna pay for it. Well, we trust in the Lord. We trust in we gonna get this car. We trust in God, and it's gonna be paid for. You in trouble. It's going back. You don't have no peace. I said, I've asked people, I said, well, can you afford it? Well, we got to trust the Lord for the extra $150. I said, you're in trouble. I said, have you been trusting God for $150 the last 2 years? Well, no, but we're going to trust him now. You're in trouble. Your faith ain't been working already, and you ain't finna crank it up like that. Now, why? Because he ain't tell you. He told me to go get a Lexus. I told y'all for years. Donnie, I told you for years the Lord gonna bless me with a new Lexus. I told y'all for years. And in 98, Jesus told me, I was driving down the street. He said, go get your Lexus. I made a U-turn in that street. I went straight to the Lexus place. He told me to get that Camry. I was on the Toyota lot. He said, pick out anything you want and put everything you want on. And I looked up and said, Lord, and I wanted to say, are you sure? But I knew better to talk like that. But I did think that. I didn't went right in there. I said, what can you put on these Camry XL? Y'all remember my gold XLE Camry? And then I got a spoiler, a CD cassette leather, gold tailpipes, gold package. I asked him, could you get anything there? He said, no, you had a bra. Y'all remember I had a bra on that thing on the front, keeping bugs off it. And the Lord told me to trust him. And they wouldn't even order my rims because I didn't have no credit, they had no job, didn't have no 1040. I didn't know what a 1040 was. But I had the voice of the Lord with me. And Jesus told me, go down to the bank and tell the bank president that I've been on drugs and robbed banks and grocery stores and restaurants and drank for years. And you tell him, I set you free. I said, I'll do it, Lord. And then Jesus said, now tell him you don't have no job. You got to trust me every month. I said, Lord, we can't tell him that. And I grieved the spirit. And the Lord left me for about 10, 15 minutes. I was sitting there just troubled. I was troubled. But whenever you disobey him, you trouble. Because there ain't no peace there when you disobey him. And so I finally said, Lord, I'll do it. This is rough. You know, because in my natural man, you can't go tell no. I'm still on chapter 13. I got another year on that. And I didn't finish paying nobody since 85. I got no credit, no job, no 1040, no 1090, no 1099, no 10, nothing. And had no money in the bank hardly. Maybe $500. But I got a God. But I got a God. I got a Master Jesus that when the Master speaks something, it'll come to pass. Was sweating. And I told him my testimony, and when I said robbing banks, he was trying to hit his button under his desk. I said, no, no, Jesus set me free. I didn't know that bothered him that bad. He wasn't even doing that when I was talking about drugs and alcohol, and I mentioned bank. He got nervous. And he said, well, young man, that's marvelous. He said, I said, well, hold on, I'm not through. Hold on. I didn't even look at him. I held my head down. I said, yeah, the Lord told me to tell you I ain't got no job. Every month I have to trust him to come through in everything. This man never seen me a day for his life. He ain't black, he's white. I'm just showing you how bad it was. And when I got through 10, I didn't have no job. And the Lord said, I raised up with confidence and said, but the Lord told me to tell you he would pay every bill. And when I said that, God, this is how I got you. I'm telling you all like sprinkles or something. A mist came in and filled that whole room. It was a mist like. And that vice president said, he stopped stuttering. He said, God is with you. They wrote me a check for $27,000. Go get that car. Don't go sad. I never miss a man. If people learn this, they ain't never got to go without no more the rest of their life. If they learn how to get in there with Jesus and let Jesus tell you what to do, Jesus will send you on a parking lot and make that man give you a car. Did he say that? God, people ain't never supposed to go without. Jesus is the way to make stuff happen by his voice. Oh, I'm telling y'all, when Jesus spoke something, I'm telling y'all, listen, we've got to get a hold of a soterian. We have got to find out what thrilled Jesus, what astonished Jesus was when the Bible said he was astonished. That this man was not from Israel. And that man had great faith. Lord, listen, you just got through telling me you're going to heal my servant. All I need now is for you to say it. You ain't got to go nowhere. Some of y'all want Jesus to come to your house. He don't need to come. You just need him to say something. Yeah. Your living room, you need him to speak. Are y'all following me? And I think we've left Jesus out of faith. And he is faith. He is the beginning and the end of faith. Now listen, in the Greek, go study it. They italicize our. It's not in the original Greek. He's the beginning and the end of how to get everything from God. Yes. He's the finisher and the beginning of faith. Jesus knows how to start and finish everything with God. And that's why we're to look unto him. He should be on our mind more than anybody else in this world. Oh, Jesus can help me. You don't hear me. Oh, the Lord, Jesus shows us what to do. Jesus turned all this around. He'll show us. He'll speak to us and tell us what to do. I just look, this is my whole Christian life. And then look at us, why y'all always so happy. I'm going to tell y'all ever see me come down here and was sad. Come on down there, when you see me come down here and be sad. And you know one of them years, you know something should have knocked my head off. Should not speak of himself. Look, the Holy Spirit, this Spirit from the Lord never speaks of himself. So what's he going to speak? The only way to hear Jesus say. Man, you ought to be close to him. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come. Now look, oh no, but no, this is good, verse 14. And in 15 takes you on the lie. He will glorify me. Listen, y'all. The Holy Spirit is not speaking to you if he ain't glorifying Jesus. If he is not pointing you to Jesus,